my childhood hero has to be Spider-Man. Not just because he liked shooting spider webs from his palms, but because he was always so unsure of himself. Like, he didn't want to be a superhero. He wasn't perfect. That just made him so much more interesting.
What was my favorite book when I was younger? It's got to be The Prince and the Pauper by Samuel Clemens. I love the story of two boys, one who is a prince and one who is a beggar, and how they look exactly alike and then they swap places. And if you read Shine, some of that got in there because there are two people who look exactly alike who somehow swap places. Did I read a lot as a child, and do I still read a lot now? Yes. I read so much that my mom went to the school library and complained to the librarian and asked her not to lend any books to me anymore because I was reading too much and not doing my chores. I only found this out recently. The librarian never told me, and she continued to lend me books. I was the kid in the schoolyard who always had her nose in a book. I was that kid in the lunchroom who was reading while she was having lunch. And I was that kid who kept getting told off for reading a book while the lessons were going on. And today, I'm that person sitting on the bus who misses her stop because she's got to finish that final chapter. I'm still reading all the time. What was the last book that was recommended to me? It was actually recommended to me by the horror writer John Mayhew. You might have heard of him, Mortlock, the nicest creepy man in the world. He said, I should read this book called The Girl with All the Gifts. It opens with this little girl, and she's in a jail cell, and it seems like it's her normal world, like it's really ordinary for her to be in the jail cell. And then this soldier comes in, and he's got a wheelchair, and he ties her up to the wheelchair and ties her neck and her head back like that. And she's really excited because it turns out she's going to class, and she goes into class, and there's her favorite teacher, and all her classmates are tied to wheelchairs. And you're like, why? Why is this going on? I couldn't put it down. It was fantastic. It was a zombie novel. I never read zombie novels, but this just goes to show, never say never. What children's book would I recommend to you? That's really difficult because I love so many books. But if I had to recommend something, I would recommend an author. I would recommend Frank Cottrell Boyce because everything he writes is just unlovable. If you read Cosmic, which is a boy who was so tall that he could pretend to be a dad and go on test drives of sports cars, or you could read Framed, which is about a whole gray, boring village in Wales who discovers art. Or you could read Millions, which is a boy who talks to saints. All Frank's books are filled with heart and beautiful writing. What advice would I give my 10-year-old self? Well, the first bit of advice is, no, you're not fat. You're okay. You look great. And the second bit of advice would be, just do what you're doing. You're gonna be fine. What would I be if I hadn't been a writer? I don't know. I didn't ever want to be anything else. If I could travel in time, where would I go first? I think I would travel back to when my babies were still babies because they're very old now and they're not cute anymore. And I would hold them and hug them and kiss them, and maybe I would take my smartphone and I would interview them so that I would have a recording of how they used to talk. How does it feel to be longlisted in The Guardian? That's how it feels. I thought nobody would notice Shine because it's kind of a quiet book. And because The Guardian has noticed it, maybe more people will read it, and that's fantastic. Thank you.